Next step. Condition for B to be first min, first maximum. First maximum. Already I explained to you at the starting. For the maximum destructive interference, here the width of the slit is divided into R part. Okay, so here for the first maxima, here this width of the slit is divided into three parts. It is divided into R number, that is three parts. Okay, so if it is divided into three parts, means we can write the path difference. The path difference delta is equal to, here it will become as delta is equal to a divided by 2 sin theta. It will become as a divided by 3 sin theta, because it is divided into 3 parts. So a divided by 3 sin theta. Okay students, so already you know the general condition for the destructive interference for maximum, that is one of the destructive interference, that is lambda delta is equal to lambda divided by 2. It is substituting this equation, means we can write condition for P to be first maximum is lambda divided by 2 is equal to a divided by 3 sin theta. Okay, so from this we can write the values of the a sin theta, means what is the values of a sin theta? A sin theta is equal to 3 lambda divided by 2. Okay students, so next we are going to condition for P to be second maxima. For second maxima, here the width is splitted into 5. So we can write delta is equal to a divided by 5 sin theta. So general path difference, that is delta is equal to a divided by 5 sin theta. The generally for the destructive interference, it is here delta is equal to lambda divided by 2. So lambda divided by 2 is equal to a divided by 5 sin theta. So we can write what is the values of the a sin theta. A sin theta is equal to 5 lambda divided by 2. This is for the second. For the third minimum maxima, for third maxima, the condition delta is equal to a divided by sin theta, a divided by 7 sin theta. So already you know the general for the destructive interference, that is lambda divided by 2 is equal to a divided by 7 sin theta. From this we can write a sin theta is equal to 7 lambda divided by 2. Okay, for the first maxima, a sin theta is equal to 3 lambda divided by 2. For second maxima, a sin theta is equal to 5 lambda divided by 2. For third maxima, a sin theta is equal to 7 lambda divided by 2. From this we can give the general equation, that is a sin theta is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda divided by 2. Okay, substitute n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. For 0, okay, 2 into 0, 0, that is lambda divided by 2. Okay, that is one of the general central maximum, when n is equal to 0, that is the central maximum. Okay, so for the first order, 2, you substitute 1 means 2 into 1. That is 2 plus 1, that is 3 lambda divided by 2. For the second order, 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 lambda divided by 2. 2 into 3, 6 plus 1, 7 lambda divided by 2. This is here the order of the diffraction for maximum. Okay. So the general maximum is called the zeroth order maximum. Okay. Zeroth order maximum is a central maximum. Okay, students. So this is one of the point of the maximum intensity lie nearly midway between the successive minima.